That is an interesting one. That could make things a bit even more competitive. And yes, a lot of baggage coming into this map after a really heavy heart for Ents out of map number one. Again, they've lost 8 series in a row, and some of them have gone 3 maps, and some of the maps have been close, but they just haven't gotten that win.
They're going to need to reverse the series now. Cloud9 to the T side, already knocking on the mini door. Isotag flashing into the garage. Alex McMeekin dies. Headshot coming in from Sunny. This bodes well for Ents' defense, at least at the start of it. Walks is the only player to get a headshot until Floppy starts to chime in. And he's got himself a second, but Heaven's already compromised. There's a player up there. Oh, but that tap and a chance to last. Floppy with the 4K. It's Ricky Camaro.
The Flop Dogster comes through with the clutch. Pulling out the Glock. What on earth was that? Super clean. Shave his head and call him Mr. Clean. He was the cleanup crew, the sanitation engineer, the snowplow, the Zamboni.
This one in mini is nice.
That's nasty.
A little labored in the end, right? It's one of those moments where you think the fourth one's just going to get away from him, but he recovers it quick enough.
Holy moly. Definitely has come close in a lot of moments like that so far on the roster. Like, we've seen them. And again, I always think about that 1v4 Astralis at Katowice. Like, one of my favorite, if not my favorite 1v4 of all time. That was, like, why I'm drinking the floppy juice.
Floppy juice.
I may say.
Can it, sell it.
And then can't open it. But he's had some close situations like that, but not close them out. There's a pretty impressive one to add to the record book.
A little bit of damage as they try to play into the ramp.
Such a hot start after a 400 round overtime, wasn't it?
Yeah, these guys not wanting any round to slip by now. No more OTs needed, I think all 10 players think. And, well, so far so good for Cloud9. Sunny's sitting on the back of the A site. And he's going to deliver us a headshot off the Deagle, as does Sadix, the base of Heaven. So suddenly it's down to the 1 versus 2. 3 kills yet again for Floppy. He's got a flash to pop out from Heaven if he really wants to. Smoke. Look at this. He's on a treasure hunt, collecting as many pieces of the puzzle he can before he delivers it on the heads of Cloud9. But Floppy with the AK at this distance should have him pinned in. A little Deagle tag goes a long way. But Sadix knows now he's got to let this one slip through the fingertips. Cloud9 going to convert, but at a cost.
Yep. 7 kills, 2 rounds in. For Floppy, and this would be the worst nightmare for Ents. Another situation where not only they could come close, but they have to go up against some, like, insane carry performance. It's not like it was once in a lifetime from Alex. He definitely is super solid on Dust 2. He's proved that, but still, the level at which we were seeing, it's not something you see every day. But some stars on Ents. That can also show face. Yumpy has that kind of level. Alu has that kind of level. Sunny did it live last match.
Deagle shots coming through the walls. AK spam through the smoke. Another round where it seems both teams are going to size each other up a little. What do you think Henry was yelling at his TV screen 3 overtimes deep last map?
Probably sounded like a Flintstone.
Still no contact onto the A site yet. The pistol players wait. What you doing, Cloud9? What you doing? Just sitting back. Ents. I'm just going to try and fortify the ramp. There's literally nobody trying to make big moves outside. Sadek's a little concerned about it. Dodo is on the door, but the Molotov does still hit his feet. That's an audio cue given over to Cloud9. The flashbang in their faces. But Sunny and Sadek's, it's Sunny yet again. 3-4 kills come in from Ents, and the flank is fantastic. Bro, they waited in lobby for far too long, doing nothing anywhere else. Those ramp players very quickly behind them.
But they were like, they're waiting there like they're waiting for Cyberpunk to come out or something.
Dude, it's been so long.
So I'll put you in that mind space for a second. Sorry to rehash a wound. I'm sure people are trying to put that out of their mind for a while.
God. It's going to get delayed again. I know it.
No, they're going to announce the delay in a few days. Don't worry.
They said the PC version's ready and they're waiting for the consoles to be perfected. It's like, excuse me, I don't care about the plebs.
Maybe you don't care about Cyberpunk at home. Probably not a lot of you, but maybe some of you. Maybe some of you here for Counter-Strike. So let's talk about that. The walkout on the L Smokes on the buy round, buy back here for Cloud9. They make a faster decision here in going into lower. They've left one outside, an inside man outside. Alu will drop a nade as he spots them crossing, and then he'll alley-oop himself with the damage on the spray. Mezzi, however, will get the trade, and he'll turn it into a 2K spray down. Wow, okay.
Peeks into the control room, shaves Woxic off the back of that. There was two players ahead of him. And now it's Dodo back on Heisenberg. Estetag planting in the corner of Old Toxic. Yumpy's going to come down the staircase. Easy kill on that one, but he looks away from Mezzi. A crucial error, especially considering that Mezzi only has 5 HP to work with. That decon player in Dodo still back there. And Floppy, a little bit worried, concerned that maybe he was coming up behind him, but that is no longer the case. An incendiary to deny vision from Floppy, and Mezzi can't actually peek into this even if he wanted to. So they're going to tap that bomb. It creates a little bit of chaos, a little bit of panic coming in from Cloud9. Ents tapping it yet again, but they've played themselves, Mohan. They're going to survive with one player. Nope. Bomb's going to kill Sunny. And that's a sweep of the CTs with the third round for Cloud9.
Well, it looked like a flub at first with that getting egoed, waiting too damn long inside of the lobby. They forgot to print the ticket. They just got in line for no reason. And by the time they came to the cash register, there was no one there. And everyone was coming in from behind. This round, they make a faster choice. Get the secret as quickly as possible. Get lower and get on site. It is was a high-risk situation. That was actually Ents' key back to an easy lead. But they'll still be able to buy in this one. And they are doing some really good work here, both outside and upstairs. And, well, Sunny will come out of the vent, get a headshot with an MP9, make it two. Everybody dies from Cloud9, and it's all in different spots.
How did they manage that?
I thought it was going to slow down for a second.
Yeah, so did I. I thought we were going back to that round three type moment, but seems not. Nicely done with the SMG from Sunny. Slips up the vent.
Well, okay.
Kicks in two, and Cloud9 take a pause off of it.
They'll call a pause to talk about it. And so this actually puts Ents in a really strong spot here because, of course, there's not much money to buy. Plus, they get that save they need, and they've kept the loss bonus at one. Alex killed every single member of Ents at least 10 times on Dust 2.
Whoa. Every single member of
every
Ents
single
at least
member
10 times.
That he killed. That's 50. That means he evenly killed every single member of Ents. Like that's how many kills he had. When what? That might be the when has that ever happened?
What? Sometimes Elliot gives you these crazy stats that just don't seem believable, but I trust him.
That is kind of insane.
No.
That is kind of insane. Every single member of a team 10 times. That has to be. That's like, that's the one Steve achievement that's keeping us away from gold.
That's the 99%
that's the arm race. That's the arm race of competitive Counter-Strike in Steve achievement terms.
Come on. I think I'm the first one. He's going to
get the opening kill, but surely Yuppie dies. Surely.
This prized possession from Alex, an M4. Now, what to do with it?
Well, they take a pseudo-tactical in the lobby.
Damn. What a long-distance headshot that is.
Can safely say I didn't see him.
Sonny's just going to tuck behind the depths of the box. Two T's cross. He's buying time. He sees Woxic. Yeah, nice little target prioritization, but gets dinked up in the process, laying down the flashbang after the fact. It is a second kill, or rather second weapon, that they could have picked up here. Where'd that other weapon go? All right, it's outside.
True, and that might be on their mind, but oh, the time actually will make it so they'll have to just commit to something. Sadix is in, you know, high risk, high reward situation. He can get the info early, but they're going to clear him. Oh my goodness. This could open things up. Do they also? Oh,
he
no,
missed.
They're going to get this kill as well. No time to drop vents. He thought about it for a second. And oh my God, it's Alu in the vents. He'll come up behind Floppy. He'll get the kill. The plant will go down. Alu misses the shot. He picks up the M4. He's going to look for the spray, and he finds it. 2-6 health on Alu.
How does he manage that, bro? He's sitting in the vent like a gremlin. It's Pennywise on the other side.
We all lop down here.
And he just sticks it to his back, bro. Come on, Alu. Look at this guy. Eyes up on the ledge of the ladder.
Just missing some red balloons. Oh my God. That's ridiculous. He misses the shot, he's supposed to die. But he uses the gun from the player he just killed. Your own weapon against you. Alu in the paint.
All right. We are right. Why does that make me? We are right back to where the antics were on Dust 2.
Right.
Like, you just said, like, oh, this is a slow start compared to what we. Sorry, you don't sound like that. This is a slow start compared to what we may be expecting from
like
the.
Like, I had glasses on, like you.
Don't take it personally. The fiesta of map one. That last round, that's chaos, bro. Floppy with the drive by from Vent. Frankie, you seeing this? Oh, sorry, you don't have your headset on yet. My bad. I just saw you out of the corner of my eye.
I was always here. I just went to get some water and then got waylaid by Jacob saying that NA players shouldn't be paid anything or something like that. I'm sure he'll fill you in on the desk later on. Just a TLDR. What's been going on, boys?
We've got Alu clutching from vents like a madman. We've got run boost with Glocks, apparently. And, Cloud9 looking to give Ents a lead.
Finally, this should mean something, right? Like, finally. Can we press tab? Just to see the rounds traded back and forth, that would be super eventually, if anything. Sadix, he's here on the flank. And it's a money-making flank. Two SMG kills for Ents. No tab. That's cool. It's been every single round, though, right?
Back and forth.
Back and forth.
Since round number three.
It's round three. Oh, true.
Actually, technically round two.
Round two.
Because Cloud9 won the conversion, and then it went back to. Okay. And I'm guessing my first gun round.
Oh my God, you were watching the whole
time.
Wow,
you were. Spectacular.
Psychic.
And Ents, they're psychos. They're on the hunt. Alu keeps opping vents. And it's working.
We got the noob tube on Yumpy. Yeah, stick a shell back in that reload. Didn't shoot. Don't worry about it. Come on. Come play hut, he asks. Sadix, quick push into the trophy room. Alex, patient as ever, over on the secret stairs, hoping somebody's going to come peeking from him. And I feel like there is a chance, you know, with Alu floating that op around in the vents, you know, eventually he could definitely justify go peeking on secret stairs. They want to gain information outdoors. But so far, it feels to me like Ents have been very content with giving outside over to Cloud9. Instead, locking them out of the bomb sites. Dodo on the heaven door. Estetag's going to walk into this on the off angle. Nice headshot. And now we have a man advantage. Sunny is beneath them. And if he goes to contest Mini, he could find the back of a many player turned. Yumpy's still trying to hope that somebody comes towards Hut, but they've completely circumvented him. Mezzy finds Sunny. That was that late lurk. But Yumpy with a shotgun headshot. Man advantage for Cloud9 with the bomb down. We've got Alu trying to soften him up inside of Mini. Perfect frag grenade from Alu. This guy sees through walls. And now Woxic's going to lay down the Molotov towards Hut. And, well, it's out from Squeaky that Yumpy comes. Or rather, Sadix. Excuse me, it's a trade frag. Woxic behind the site itself. Yumpy incredibly low on HP. Check out S-Attack. He's going to go for that last second re-rotation over towards the Mini. Alu cuts him down right there, but Alu loses his teammates in the process and then his head. Cloud9 tie. It's four rounds each.
Ends couldn't see it, but Cloud9 had too many things in place to make sure they couldn't lose that round. And we saw Ents jump over all of those obstacles and clear them one at a time, but there was just no way to get over every single one of them. With the player in heaven, the way that they were set up on the site, that was actually an impossible retake, which is pretty cool. It was also cool to see Ents almost squeeze water from stone and find a way out of that. But now we go into this round. Cloud9 tie it up once again. And Ents, it's a round where they force, but they have some concessions. They're focusing in here on the op of Alu and working around it.
Little wall of smokes to work with. Alu adds one to the collection, doesn't want to be left out. Creates a bit of ambiguity for Cloud9. They look to punish the reload. Dodo just dives into the smoke. You saw nothing. He comes back with a knife out. Estetag's going to catch the kill. He's blinded, enough so that Alu can come into this, but Alex trades him, and a nice shot from Woxic to deny Sunny any chance at keeping this one even. MP9 and a 5-7. Alex getting tested for Mini, finds his kill, and despite this peek from Sadix, you'd think it's not enough, but of all the players to kill, he takes down the bomb carrier and then creates a temporary bit of cover to try and lock down bomb. Will Mezzy predict that he is peeking over it? He's too worried about his flank. If he disengages, gives that bomb away, maybe he could still find himself in the right position once Cloud9 make their final move.
Yeah, good point. True test for the young gun. And since he's on CD side, the option might come to him, but okay, Woxic just too patient, sitting there. Great round from Woxic, punishing the Mini player, punishing the back hell player, having a ton of impact in that very strange interaction to kick things off. You can't forget about this. The smokes that come down both ways. Ultimately, Alu getting sprayed down through the smoke and Mini not able to have impact with that op. And finally, we have a situation where Ents have no choice but to save. And I say that as in either team will finally just have to save. Which should imply that the other team should win, but we don't know.
As he gets the double off the Galil, it's a desperate attempt from Ents to just charge the base of the silo. They were hoping for way more than just that. They'll get one kill to the player on top. Cloud9, six rounds on this T side.
It's kind of nuts because there's actually nothing to talk about yet that's of value when it comes to Cloud9's T side. It's both of their ability to eco the other one back in very awkward spots. And some very exciting rounds, the 1v4 from Floppy, the 1v2 from Alu, great clutches. But strategically, it doesn't seem like that is make or break at any point. They could start this map over now, and I feel like neither of them can tell you what the other intended to do properly. Now, we'll see. This might be one of those defining rounds where they're finally past the chaos.
Barrage of smoke grenades comes over.
I think this is that Blame F lurk that we saw. I think S-Attack does this sometimes. Yeah, the S-Attack actually did this once or twice in their last, in their first nuke game versus ZenIP. And Blame F likes his play a lot. Yeah, the credit card swipe and he gets a kill, but there's two in garage.
Yeah, they chase him down. Sadix was being called over just in case. That did create a window of opportunity. If they wanted to try and run out ramp, because Alex dies so quick, it's a reset. Dodo, he hits the headshot but doesn't get the kill. S-Attag milks the AK. Mezzy's gonna fall off of the rooftop after having thrown some utility inwards. Check out Yumpy, he's compromised. 50 HP, S-Attag with another. He's got two kills off of the 10 HP. And then they evacuate with bomb down vent. Sonny finds Woxic. Mezzi late peek gets both the plays so that he doesn't have to go for the post plant, but just legit wins it before the bomb plant needed.
That's all about Essatag. He gets a pre-fire second kill and the opening outside vent. Dodo, tough position. That's going to happen. You see how beautiful that looks from Estag's perspective. And if he sprays there and there's no one there, they get the vent dive. So it's almost like, why wouldn't you pre-fire in some sense? Ends call for attack timeout here. And this is a little bit of a weird one too. It's hard to say. Like, shutting down Squeaky Regression is, of course, cornerstone to a CT side defense. But whether or not Cloud9 will go back there is a different question.
Dojo has become the first player to get two aces at this event after his overtime ace on Dust 2.
Oh.
Damn.
Well, that's cool, considering he's only played one match.
This is his third match with them. So
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point. Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Yeah, true, true. That's cool. And what was it, two aug aces? Or I remember one.
We may not have seen the second because we didn't cast that game.
Oh, well, that was from the other match. I got you. I thought it was in the same game. My goodness.
Me too. Yeah, my bad.
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I've just gaslit both of you.
Wait,
you
till
would do that.
Wait till the next course.
I just
want to
know if you did it on purpose or not.
Elliot will show us the way. He'll confirm.
Alu. Not going to find anything with the smoke in his face and a flash over Mini. Let's see if the pistol pop from Ents can catch a couple of the Cloud9 members off guard. Got a man over in secret. Hell, they've got a player tucked in Mini, too. I feel like Cloud9 have been maximizing a little bit of effort outdoors. We've seen Alex kind of get over towards credit card, play around, trying to get into hell. Hasn't gotten that far. We've seen Essatag outside of heaven once or twice. But again, Ents playing a reserved defense, kerneled inside the buildings. Alu's scout will find one. Now he's down to half health. Mezzi and Floppy with two headshots, bringing it back. Alu staying focused, though, because this scout could still make a world of difference. He spotted the shoulder, but didn't stick around for it. He wants to fade away instead. If he didn't, he's blind. There is a chance.
That's true.
Sonny, a little bit more deagle damage, but Floppy.
It's a big first hit.
Yeah, he's getting them out. Now we've got Sadix inside of the vent.
Oh,
he sees two players crossing, but the moment he breaks it, Mezzi was focused on him. Alu, two kills on the play. Chance for more. Third scout frag. His for the ta- Oh my, Alu is on for the eighth. He's going to switch over to the Galil. Mezzi, a 3K on this one if he can shut down the Alu show. And the door is busted open, but Mezzi gets around it.
That's so sick.
And now either Alu tells him by swinging this open, or he just doubles back through Hut. That is still the possibility if he milks the time. But Alu, because this was not a full buy, doesn't have the kit, and he gives himself over to Mezzi. An awesome attempt from Alu.
And a nicely played 1v1 from Mezzi. Always a shame almost when you see the counterplay in the 1v1. That's just as sweet, because this 1v3 would have been a supreme highlight. Nice second shot here from Alu.
Ooh. Dirt nasty.
He does seem prescient in those 1vx situations. Good at keeping the inventory of the other players and reading into their next moves. Well, there's some... Oh, preemptive damage here. Sonny's going to have the door blown open in front of him. Damage onto Essatag, but the rush is canceled completely. It looked like they were going to commit.
Does it feel to you, Launders, like Cloud9 are going to master Nuke?
I don't know about master. I was thinking when you said that like the problem with Nuke is that it's an elite team map and that the competition skill ceiling gets super high on Nuke for when it comes to the vetoes at tier one. So I want to say like I'm definitely liking what I see with some of the executions and everything, but if I think it'll become a home map for them, I think for sure. But if they can keep up with everybody, I don't know.
Do you think they picked it because Ents have got new two players and this is quite a technical map?
I think that, and I think they just are, like, since it's Ents, I think they definitely feel like they can beat Ents as well.
Dodo, lucky to be alive. 2 points of health. Sunny, peeking out from the vent, dies at the hands of Woxic. They are looking at a 9th round on the T side. If they can just convert what has been heavy damage and a lower B control. Take a look at the map real quick. Nobody from Ents is downstairs yet. They are all on the upper level. And they're being heard by Mezzi as well. So Estetag is going to go ahead and plant and cover. Nobody can stop him. He may be burned out into the open, but Mezzi and Woxic delivering kills. It's all who Statics to answer, but down goes the offer. Everything from Mezzi.
Heads up.
He plays that close proximity.
Go on then.
And just busts him.
Go on then,
Rule Britannia.
What's that?
It's he's British.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
But we're not.
Yeah, but he's British.
Is it the dictionary? Always said, why did I tell them that? The three letters that stopped that after 3 letters.
It's the thing, you're part of our Commonwealth. We own you.
Whoa!
Unfortunately,
that is another bad thing I've said about people's countries today.
We didn't
I'm
fight
so
for our freedom.
Sorry.
It's in your blood.
My government
blood, Frankie,
is a mess.
It's in your blood.
I'm just jealous of all of you, okay? I want to be Finnish.
You're too funny, Frankie.
No.
That's what my mother says.
Let's see it. Sad dicks. Can he deliver with the frag grenade? Deagle up along with Dodo and Sunny and Alu too. So these hand cannons. This is what I want to see, man. A little life out of Ents at the end of this half. Because, I mean, after the comeback on map one, we have to give them the respect. We got to believe a little. A little. Now they're starting to get outclassed again. Alex. Walking through secret. Look at the CT starting to shuffle upwards. Vox is just going to pop somebody with a sidearm like it's nobody's business. Flash grenade down into the A site. Another kill for Cloud9. MP9 for Yumpy.
Oh, now they have to go A.
Yeah, and he's down to 11 health. Might as well just chuck it over to... Oh, okay.
I thought those CTs
Floppy
came in and killed him.
Thinks he's Batman up there on the roof.
Look at that. Oh. He's going to find another... Statics goes down. Floppy ends this one. Cloud9, double digits for the T side of Nuke. There's that million-dollar
there
smile.
Jon Snow. He almost got cast in Game of Thrones to be Jon Snow. That would have been him. But he was too good at CS. He was up on the high wall... shooting down the White Walkers.
You guys have to stop making
Game of Thrones reference. Did you watch it?
I don't get it. I don't get it.
You don't get it?
I don't know what's going on. I'm
sure you get it. You know who Jon Snow is.
I know who John Wick is.
Pervaded popular culture.
You know nothing, Scorny. That's all I'm saying.
And you probably only know who John Wick is because of Cyberpunk. But anyways, we got a full rifle round coming up. Dodo door swings open. Dodo will punish, which is huge. 5v4 as he retains mini control, and he'll actually come back into the fight. Look at this re-entering. This though good with the smoke. Ooh. That's a beautiful play by Dodo. The trades come back. Oh my goodness. Is this actually going to work out? Oh no. The drop comes in. Cloud9, they're in lower. Has anybody made a rotation? Nothing from the CT side just yet.
Smoke grenade out for Estetag. He's trying to get Floppy into the bomb site. Frag grenade almost blows him away. 14 health for Floppy. 48 on Estetag. There's no reason to believe that they should be able to hang on to this post plant. They've got the Molotovs and a flash, in fact. But we've already got this B bomb site enveloped by Ents. It's a matter of pushing over the final hurdle, and it's from control that Alu does find Estetag. Floppy's position, he is 19-7 here on Nuke.
Oh, what's the play?
The Molly. Oh, he's going to round it. Yeah. He's going to wrap it all the way around. There's no kit on the play launders.
They have the stick from the other side.
Floppy, he's going to find their backs turn, but it's a 10-second defuse. Doors go wide. He gets them off, and a second headshot from Floppy. He started this half with a clutch, and he ends it with 1-2.
Well, well, well. What do we have here? 11-4 rears its ugly head again. Last time that this went down on Dust 2, it went all the way to OT. But that was with Cloud9 struggling to find rounds on T side. Now it's going to be about Ents trying to figure out if they can manufacture an 11-round comeback to the victory. That will be difficult, to say the least.
Two smokes, two flashbangs. That's what Ents have gone for in the pistol. They are both already thrown up the wall. Good thing there's nobody in garage, or else they'd still have the vision. A very passive Cloud9 pistol. Flashbang over top, so now that uncertainty caused in the back of Cloud9's minds. Alex actually does get eyes above it. And Floppy's gonna go ahead and jump downstairs just in case. He is 21-7. As we saw, ending the half with a clutch, starting the half with a clutch.
1v3 there, 1v4 in the pistol.
Oof. See if maybe he needs to come back into it with another bit of clutch. Alex, he's got a lot of players over here in decon. Walks, he's got himself a headshot. 2T's still up, no bomb plant, bomb thrown into the open. Alu finally gonna fight back, but it is a little too late.
This is just a dog pile of bodies on the stairs. They couldn't even rotate. That wasn't even a sight. They were just trying to get out of there. What is this? Cloud9 said stay in place. 12-4 after this. Disgusting shutdown, the mowdown to protect the vents.
I see a P90.
Oof. A viable gun on many maps, Art would say. On Nuke in particular, many more would say.
Bomb is good for two. Thanks to Estetag, door swings open. Alex with the triple, 50 bullets in the magazine. It's basically a garden hose.
That's the thing, never run out of ammo. And hopefully for Ents, never run out of hope. Again, just a miraculous comeback in that first game, but still, it was to a loss. It would be another heartbreaking loss to tack on to their 8-series loss streak. But this Cloud9 CT side is like the, you know, in general, it seems like the CT sides are where they're really shining. And so much good to say about Nuke when it comes to Estetag and Floppy at ramp. A lot of power here. We're seeing them both already come into play. Almost getting that second. It's this Molly that spreads at the end after the tag to slow him down. They can't run. And now Floppy's up to bat. Fomist in hand. He'll lock down two kills. You're kidding. With the last bullet. And for Sunny to flip around only to see a P90 shoved down his neck.
Alex wasting no time with the hut flank. Runs through the Molotov on the ramp room just to make sure he gets that job done. Nicely done here for Ricky.
He had a switch. You see that? He switched right at the end.
Chilling on the box. 14 rounds for Cloud9. Ents, this is going to be a very difficult T side. And now we're starting to realize the picture that could have been. Cloud9, this could have been done an hour ago. They could have genuinely had their heyday. But Ents' perseverance on Dust 2 pushed them to the absolute limit. Floppy's going to rotate down into the B site in case there's players here. And sure enough, there is. In fact, there's a bomb. Just defuse it, Floppy. Just defuse it.
He should at least go just tap it, if anything, but he has no a player on the other side. The rest of the T's will die. They're sitting down in the vent. They're coming through the flank. This might be a free kill. We'll see. It ends up costing a teammate a death, and now they're rotating it from up top, but Mezzi, he's so aware.
By the time Sunny can get into position to even try to contest it, it's already gone. Slipping through the fingertips of Ents, a 15th round from Cloud9. This CT side looking like it's going to be a quick one.
Gentlemen, don't you dare put those jackets on. Because the last time that happened, we had 18 more
rounds of
Counter-Strike.
I'm putting the jacket on. It's not going to happen. It won't happen. I'm willing to say that after what we just saw.
Sure.
I'm putting my pride on the line. I'm taking a risk. It's not going to happen. It will not happen.
If it does
Don't turn
happen,
the lights on, production. I'm not that serious. Like, yeah. Come on. Who knows? Might be a few more.
No. We'll see. I mean, I'm all for it. We got an awesome competitive first map. I don't know. Nuke just looks like Cloud9's specialty for the moment. Alex kind of stuck out the rafters. A site is in question. 3 kills for Ents across the bomb site.
Taking my jacket off.
But wait, walks a little trigger discipline. He's going to find one on Tweaky. Goes back for Alu. Can't quite kill him. And he will get there in the end, but the reload's going to cost him because Yumpy comes through the hut. Here's Floppy for another clutch, but Sunny down beneath his feet skewers shots right through him.
A nice T explode into upper. And again, we restart the story. Will there be enough significant good rounds here for Ents to stage a comeback? I mean, at least get them to a respectable scoreline. At least maybe we can tell that story, which might be a bit more reasonable. Dignity rounds, if anything, to show us maybe, oh, what if they started on this half? But I think they had choice and wanted to go for CT first. So, Floppy has really had a huge makeover in the last couple of maps with Cloud9. Again, his first four maps, I think bottom fragged on Cloud9. Every single map looked totally uncomfortable. And since then, has had a couple of star player performances.
That he has. He's going to be tested yet again. Finds the quick headshot into Sunny, evacuates ramp, calls Woxic into the equation. He's going to have to dodge that flashbang, which does allow two T's to drop down. And Alu finds him before he decides to go and explore over towards Hell. A new avenue opened.
Do you really want a dual Floppy coming down the ramp? That's the question. And look at this. He's actually... Are they pushing up close? Oh, no. He'll get the kill on Dodo. Even Dodo seemed aware. Floppy was the one who looked like his aim was most displaced.
And A-site's still fine.
Yeah, and he got info on ramp. He knows they're not committing lower. This might not be a secret.
Mezzi on high alert does a little bit of damage, but it's Sadix to come in through Mini. Floppy, 2 kills to his name. Wow. Half health on all 3 of the remaining members. You know, I like that you mentioned how Floppy has looked better in recent maps with Cloud9, because I think a lot of Cloud9's critics became more vocal when they saw the...
The
flare of the picks kind of come out, right? It fizzled out a little. You know, Mezzi was this unknown entity and kind of felt like maybe a filler. And then when Floppy was just retained on Cloud9, if you weren't a Floppy fan...
If you weren't an NA... Like, if you just watch NACS, basically...
Then you could
like,
see, but, you know...
Obviously, everybody over on our side of the...
Has been talking about how Floppy can take over, how Floppy could compete at these levels, how Floppy could have technically been a pickup for some of our top organizations.
It's kind of like how everyone in the UK knew all about Mezzi, and we didn't. And I had to watch demos to see, but there were still only tier 2 games, a huge question mark.
I once produced an event that Mezzi played at.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, what, Insomnia, I think it was 2017.
Do you have a Mezzi story? Anything?
Well, I put him on stage, so I definitely met him. I think he was on Dog Gaming or some kind of mixed team like that.
Great name.
Yeah, they came second, but I definitely would have probably taken his coat or put him on stage.
If you can, you know, describe your team in one word, Dog?
Yeah, Dog. Did he always have that little, like, Johnny Depp mustache?
I wish I could remember. I feel like all boys of his age as he was back then tried to have the Johnny Depp mustache.
I'm still trying. My other question is, are you sure he's not Maudie?
Yeah, he looks so much like Maudie.
Who's Maudie?
Maudie, the Swedish Counter-Strike player.
Ooh.
Just from time ago.
Ooh, all right, Ents, they're going to get through it. Sunny with the 3K versus the lesser weapons. I mean, it's happening. It's happening.
Are you really saying that? Are you really saying that right now?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
Well, production have lowered the lights, so
they did lower the
thing.
Lights. I got a little nervous when they did that.
You willing to put that jacket on the line, Launders?
I'm going to keep the jacket.
If
sweat.
This goes to overtime,
I'm going to sweat.
That's mine.
This was expensive. And it won't fit you.
It's the pride, though. He's going to frame it.
But he's going to throw it in the garbage. This is mine. I'm going to burn it in front of you.
All right, Dutty Dotto. Toto's other ace was a sensational M4 hold on the B side of Overpass in the 3v5. It was one of our top 5 plays of the day yesterday.
Well,
if they come back, I'll give you this jacket.
Yeah? Everybody watching, if Ents get this to overtime, that blue jacket is mine with the pocket square.
The pocket square is really expensive.
Then throw your watch.
Without the pocket square, I'll give you this jacket.
All right. It's on the line. It's on the line.
And I won't be the slightest bit biased.
well, bye that they're going to have to get through, dude.
Yeah. Let's see what they can do. They've had a really, really strong upper explode. And the aim was sharp in that round where they came upstairs. The play they made to kill Mezzi was a standard one, but they were aware of his position underneath the heavens. So that was a really strong move. S-Tag will try to deal now with this upper exec. He spins around to try to trade out Jumpy, who knows that there's actually someone on his trail, hot on his trail. And he'll win the duel. What is that? Spray control. First tap into a spray headshot. Jumpy looks to make another kill happen. Beautifully done.
Floppy's going to have to fall back to spawn. That AUG, all they'll have in the next one. Ents just kind of smashing into this A site a couple rounds now. Jumpy with the multi-kill. We saw Sunny with the 3K last time. To keep three players alive is big. Make sure that if any close rounds happen, we're not going to find some of these weird moments where Ents just fizzle out.
I do think definitely the game plan should just be like, not like, just don't really mess with Floppy too much. He's such a perfect player for like the small sites for ramp and stuff like that because he's so comfortable in taking that very, very hard first duel. That's the really cool thing about Floppy. Extremely clean aim. I mean, he is well-rounded, so he could probably play a lot of spots, but for those particularly difficult positions to get the one kill you need, it feels like he is so reliable. But yeah, so far so good in avoiding him at least. And we see the fire.
A little fired
there.
Up, man.
That's what we love to see. You know, never, never, ever giving up, because why should you?
You've only truly lost once you stop believing in yourself. Mohan Govindasamy.
That's a ninja quote. Stop it. When you've lost twice.
That's one man left in lobby.
That's what Ents can't afford to do.
Check out Cloud9 coming to explore and pick up some pieces.
For what it's worth, they know it's not an upper explode now.
Yeah, but something Dota's interesting. Back here.
Yeah, Dota's all. Oh, he's definitely going to shoot him in the side of the head as soon as he gets up on the silo.
Yep, and that saves his teammates, but. I thought maybe more of the CTs were going to try and come to get the back
flash
of Ents. Not the case. They moved two players back down into
they
ramp.
They all rotated lower.
Yo, Mezzi. Oh, he's going to get over to Decon.
This is timing.
They've got Yumpy and Sunny over on the control. Alu just crossed with the op. 50 seconds on the clock.
They're not learning anything.
Nope.
But so much is happening. Oh, my God. He's already in control.
Yeah. Now Woxix back down beneath the dark. Mezzi swings the door open. So Decon, they now know is a problem. We've got the bomb moving through vents. Mezzi, he could look to stop it, but Alu, he peeks around the corner. Estetag have already offered the A site and a good dodge from Ents to get away from
that
the B.
That was actually such a nice call. I mean, how do they even know, you know, Woxic is in their double stack? That's actually so beautiful from Ents. And Alu covering on Mezzi as he spots the cross. Everything worked really well there. So in this next round, look, I mean, that is just the Deagle round, so we'll see what happens into the next round. But I think if I'm Cloud9, my game plan is thinking about probably going aggressive for an opening kill, honestly, because Ents, when they're wrapping for the upper explodes, it's working out really well. And I feel like they should be comfortable with something like Floppy either leaving his post for a few seconds or pushing up a little bit aggressively, because I feel like he's, if there's any, if conditioning means anything, they should be really worried about actually focusing around towards him. So trying to get Floppy involved in whatever round is coming and maybe assuming that Floppy isn't going to have early fights. I feel like those are the things I'd be thinking about if I was Cloud9.
Oh, Cloud9, gonna have to calculate their decisions. Woxic gets the op. And no, it's right back to the AUG. Two AUGs, AK and an M4. Something quick out of Ents, perhaps. I see three players in the lobby. Looking like they want to spread out a little. Sunny taking to the top of Silo. Alu anticipating some sort of a walk-up. If you think back just to the eco, Cloud9 found that lobby for free. So I could understand why Ents would maybe think they'd try the same thing with weapons, in which case they're going to walk right into that scope.
Oh, they're actually leaning towards ramp. He's got the crack spot, so yeah, he'll be able to drop that down. Minute 13, not much has changed. Estetag pulls in here. Doesn't mean that Ents are going to commit, though. They start to move back towards lobby, making a lot of noise. Whoa. This is interesting. They're actually pulling to outside completely, leaving Dodo inside. And if I'm Cloud9, I'm pretty scared of an upper hit coming. So maybe this could be a smart play. But what comes next is the question. I would be pretty confused at this moment. But look, Floppy, I think he does push up.
Yeah, he's starting to at least piece it together. Three players stacked on this A site.
Oh, no, he's just tucked in the corner, actually.
Smoke's now faded. Alu still trying to give that support. They're going to go for the same boost we just saw. Still unable to find Floppy. He's changed his position slightly. This is going to be him tested. Decides to shoot Yumpy in the side of the head. Or rather, that's Woxic with the AWP. Floppy, T takes down two. 4 versus 2 for Cloud9. Esta tag slips into Hut, and that is a 16th round for Cloud9. They're going to go ahead and finish it off on Nuke.